Shalom, Kol Laimla, Yahweh, Hashem Yahweh Shai, Hashem Rekwal Kadash. All praises be to the Most High, Yahweh, in the name of His Son, and our Lord and Savior, Yahweh Shai. Much respect and honor to the brothers that are doing the work in truth and sincerity, risking their lives and freedom to do so, pushing this gospel throughout the four corners of the earth. Salutations to the hopeful elect that are scattered abroad, and double honor and respect to the elders and the apostles of Great Millstone. Coming back at you in another lesson entitled, Take Not Thy Holy Spirit Away From Me. One of the signs of falling out of the truth, well, really the first sign, is losing the anointed oil, which gives us the understanding of the scriptures, gives us a moral compass, and enables us to navigate through these waters and through these living waters, which is this full gospel. So we're going to go into a few videos, and then we're going to go into the scripture. And I will say a couple of things before I proceed. I did get the results of the ultrasound on my neck, and I have four thyroid nodule lumps in my throat. But through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai, I've been able to keep going. And eventually I'll be able to get these removed from my neck. I don't want to rub this out. So we're going to go ahead and go into a couple of videos. Through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai, we can do all things, and we are healed through our faith in His word. I want to go here to these videos, and this is coming off of a lesson that the beloved Elder Manata Zak did of South Carolina. Let's play these videos.
Among us, believing that King David is among us and that he will be manifest, and I believe the same thing. I'll go ahead and put it out there. So now you can go ahead and send the video to whoever got to be sent to, right? And do whatever it is you got to do, because it's all the spirit. And we'll go from there, because that's the part of the division. I believe King David is among us as well, and that Ha'adawan Yahawah Yahawah Shai is going to manifest King David, and that's according to the scriptures, according to the spirit, right? According to the spirit. That's what I believe, and that's what I have believed for some time, right? And as many things as you come into the truth, that you taught and understand, some things being right, some things, you know, not always being on point.
And the thing to keep in mind here is, and this is what this young man is failing to realize, the Most High is the greatest chess player of all time. So he's going to strategically move or raise up his king when he is ready to. A great chess player is not going to just throw out his king where any pawn or where any opposing force can just take out his king. So why can't we just follow what the apostles teach us? Why is that so hard? And this young man, along with many others, are failing to realize that. The Most High, this is his chessboard. And strategically moving the righteous pieces against the red adversarial pieces. So this is his program, not ours. And the apostles were given the instructions by which to follow. Let's go to the next video.
What do I do? You know you're everything I knew. Oh yeah.
You can't make this shit up, man.
But I shake the room.
War ready. Wow. It's a scary thing to lose the Spirit of the Lord. It is very scary. The thought of it is scary. So when the Spirit leaves us, we are walking dead. And that's a fact. And this is really sad to see this. This is a sad thing to see. It is the Spirit that quickeneth. The flesh profiteth nothing. So the Spirit gives us the breath of life. What I'm seeing here is an image of death. Let's go here. So the Spirit gives us the breath of life, wisdom, knowledge, and understanding. And it gives us a torch, which shows us how to walk in this truth. Let's go here first, one moment. I'm gonna go to, we're gonna pick back up at 10:30. There's a key point that I wanna expound upon. Let's go here first. So we're gonna talk a little bit about King Saul. And it's still a sad way in which Saul perished. This was a man that was anointed, and a man, he was a man of the Lord. Go to 1 Samuel 16. Let's go to verse. It's acting up. It never did this in the past. 1 Samuel 16 and 14. We're messing with the app. 1 Samuel 16. Let's go to verse 14. Oh, we got to go up. We're going to go to verse 13. Then Samuel took the horn of oil and anointed him in the midst of his brethren, and the Spirit of the Lord came upon David from that day forward. So Samuel rose up and went to Ramah, but the Spirit of the Lord departed from Saul, and an evil spirit from the Lord troubled him. So a man is known by his countenance. So an evil spirit manifests itself, is what it does. And it puts a cloak of darkness and dark energy around us. When the Spirit leaves, we begin to do things on the outward appearance that is a mere reflection of what's happening to the inner man. Let's see if I can find that. I think it's, let's see here. Let's go to Sirach 19. Let's read this one. Sirach 19, verse 20. The fear of the Lord is all wisdom, and in all wisdom is the performance of the law and the knowledge of his omnipotency. Let's go here. I'm going to go right here. Beautiful. Sirach 19, verse 29. A man may be known by his look, and one that have understanding by his countenance when thou meetest him. See, a man's attire and excessive laughter and gait show what he is. So sometimes what's happening on the inside begins to show on how we carry and conduct ourselves, how we walk. The Bible says King David walked in wisdom. Doing a video like this and putting war ready is not walking in wisdom at all. And this is heavy. This title here is spiritual. Don't forget where you came from. This man had the anointing oil on him. So he came from the anointed. This is a sad thing to see here. Let's go back to this team. What's going on here? One moment.
Lady, what do I do? You know you're everything I need. Oh, yeah.
The hell is this? Let's keep going. I mean, oh, my goodness. So, back to 1 Samuel 16, verse 14. But the Spirit of the Lord departed from Saul, and an evil spirit from the Lord troubled him. And Saul's servants said unto him, Behold, now an evil spirit from the Most High troubleth thee. So we can look at an individual quite often, if we're in the spirit, and know that something just ain't right. Something just ain't right. My goodness. Then the lyrics go on to say, Ooh, you've been cheating on me. Tell me it's a lie. So spiritual fornication, deviating from our holy covenant, our marriage vows, which is this word. The Most High has set in order the apostles to give them his chess strategy. Okay? And part of that includes the position of the king. So if they say it's King Marsha, then we teach what the apostles teach. Let's go to 2 Samuel 1, verse 21. Context here. David's dirge for Saul and Jonathan. 2 Samuel 1, verse 17. And David lamented with this lamentation over Saul and over Jonathan, his son. They would fall by the Philistines in battle. Also, he bade them teach the children of Judah the use of the bow. Behold, it is written in the book of Jasher, the beauty of Israel is slain upon thy high places. How are the mighty fallen? Tell it not in Gath, publish it not in the streets of Ashkelon, lest the daughters of Philistines rejoice, lest the daughters of the uncircumcised triumph. Ye mountains of Gilboa, let there be no dew, neither let there be rain upon you, nor fields of offerings, for there the shield of the mighty is vilely cast away, the shield of Saul, as though he had not been anointed with oil. So King Saul was anointed, but he lost the oil, which essentially means he received a death sentence. Lack of understanding means void of life, darkness. It is the spirit that quickeneth, the flesh profiteth nothing. So the spirit makes us alive. So he had already received the death sentence when he lost the oil, the anointing, which is the protecting covering of the Holy Spirit. Let's read that again. Ye mountains of Gilboa, let there be no dew, neither let there be rain upon you, nor fields of offerings, for there the shield of the mighty is vilely cast away, the shield of Saul, as though he had not been anointed with oil. even, let's go to verse 22. 2 Samuel 1, verse 22. From the blood of the slain, from the fat of the mighty, the bow of Jonathan turned not back, and the sword of Saul returned not empty. Saul and Jonathan were lovely and pleasant in their lives, and in their death, they were not divided. They were not divided. They were swifter than eagles. They were stronger than lions. Mighty men, fallen. And this is a tragic ending. Let's keep going. So this truth is a net, where we're either caught up in the net to be delivered, or trapped and ensnared in the gin of our destruction, a booby trap. Let's go to Psalms 51. They're messing with this again. I'm going to go to Psalms 51. Excuse me. Yep. 3 thyroid nodules in my neck. But through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bashem, Yahweh Shai, I will be healed. Let's go here to Psalms 51. Go to verse. Wait a minute. Before we go there, we need to get another scripture. One moment. Let's go here to John. John, somewhere around verse 9. Let's go to John chapter 9. No, 3. Chapter 3. And we're going to go. Let's go up here into verse 1. This is Yahweh Shai speaking to Nicodemus, a high-ranking Jew. John chapter 3, verse 1. There was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. The same came to Yahweh Shai by night and said unto him, Rabbi, we know that thou art a teacher come from the Most High, for no man can do these miracles that thou doest except the Most High be with him. John 3 and 3. Yahweh Shai answered and said unto him, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a this is heavy here. Now, verily, verily means truly, truly. John 3, verse 3. Yahweh Shai answered and said unto him, Verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of the Most High. So this is being washed by the word, renewed, coming back on the earth, even through our mother's womb. The Most High gives us a fresh start. So this is becoming like a child and being taught like a child, not just taking what we have from our own mind, but following the prescribed order and the instruction booklet given to us from our spiritual fathers. So subduing our own understanding, being renewed through the Spirit. Let's go to Psalms 51. See, Psalms 51. Let's go to verse 5. Behold, I was shapen in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. So in this flesh, we're born in a state of sin to go off. But the Spirit renews us. This is a heavenly doctrine and cannot be marginalized or taken for granted, or putting our own spin on what the Most High is doing from the big picture, understanding the big picture of the chess player. the will of the Father, and whose instructions has been passed down through Yahawashi, through the disciples and the men of the Lord. Psalms 51, verse 6. Behold, thou desirest truth in the inward parts, and in the hidden part thou shalt make me to know wisdom. See? So that wisdom is the renewal of our mind through the Spirit of truth. Not walking in our own wisdom or man's wisdom. The Most High is the greatest chess player of all time, and he can send strong delusion to those that are forsaking the gospel built upon the apostles, the prophets, the chief cornerstone. Going against that means going against the Most High, the chess player. Make me to hear joy and gladness, that the bones which thou hast broken may rejoice. So we became fractured, a broken people, scattered, the valley of the dry bones, void of water, which is the overflowing waters of life. The wisdom and understanding given to us from on high. Let's go to verse 9. Hide thy face from my sins and blot out all mine iniquities. That's washing away, purging away the filth of the old man. What is that? Not being able to take rebuke. Not being able to take correction. Not being able to be told that we're going off. Not being able to come under order. That's the old man, which is a rebel, a vigilante. See? We cannot be joined into a brotherhood thinking as an individual. Period. See? Hide thy face from my sins and blot out all mine iniquities. How? Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Let's read that again. Create in me a clean heart, O God, and renew a right spirit within me. Cast me not away from thy presence, and take not the Holy Spirit from me. So a clean heart, which means we got to be born again. The waters that we come through were shaped or reshaped through the Spirit, washed, renewed. Let's go to John 3, verse 5. Yahawashi answered, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of the Most High. So this renewal or this rebirth is a spiritual baptism. We want to cling on to, you can't tell me what to do. I'm a man. Don't correct me. I know I'm right. What brotherhood? Anybody outside of the brotherhood or coming against the brotherhood is not in the truth. How do we know that? Well, I'm going to prove it. Let's see. Let's go to 1 Peter 1. Book of 1 Peter chapter 1. Let's go to verse 21. Who by him do believe in the Most High, that raised him up from the dead and gave him glory, that your faith and hope might be in the Most High, seeing ye have purified your souls in obeying the truth through the Spirit and unto unfeigned love of the brethren. Woo! Are we going to just speak against the brethren and the brotherhood and recreate the will and revise the doctrine? That's what Esau does. Every English dictionary, revision number 12, number 13, the revised Webster dictionary. What the hell is this? Let's read that again for those that think this is an individual effort that doesn't affect the whole. The part affects the whole. You step on a man's finger and let's see if he ignores it. Oh, that's just my pinky. Or that's just my pinky toe. No, it doesn't work that way. Let's read that again. 1 Peter 1, verse 22. Seeing ye have purified your souls in obeying the truth through the Spirit unto unfeigned love of the brethren, see that ye love one another with a pure heart, fervently. That means with all tenacity, energy, and strength and might to love each other. That's coming under this doctrine, the charity and teaching and preaching. The same doctrine, the same Spirit, one body, one Spirit. See, being born again. Say what? Being born again, not of corruptible seed, but of incorruptible by the word of the Most High, which liveth and abideth forever. So the doctrine does not get revised. It's one doctrine, one Spirit. Or Ephesians 4, verse 3, endeavoring to keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. That's the brotherhood. That's the building of the Lord's temple with tempered mortar. The true doctrine, one doctrine. The greatest chess player says, my king is King Mashiach, but damn it, that's what we teach. Okay? He's the master builder, the master chess player, and has commissioned and ordained other master builders. Ephesians 4, verse 3, endeavoring to keep the unity of the Spirit in the bond of peace. There is one body and one Spirit, even as ye are called in one hope of your calling, one Lord, one faith, one baptism. See, being born again through the spiritual immersion of this doctrine, into this doctrine, for being immersed into pure doctrinal truth, a purifier soap. One Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in you all. So the master chess player has given us a strategy. He is the commander in chief. So we are to follow order. Let's go to that brotherhood. I think it's 2 Peter. 1 Peter 2 and 17. Honor all men. Love the brotherhood. No, we're going to just hate the brotherhood. Let's blame the brotherhood because we want to deviate from the doctrine. 1 Peter 2, verse 17. Honor all men, love the brotherhood, fear the Most High, honor the King. See? That's the Most High, and Yahweh Shai. And the greatest chess player protects his king. You don't speak against the king. See? Let's go to verse 18. Servants, be subject to your masters with all fear, not only to the good and gentle, but also to the froward. Be subject. So this is a governing body that's being established. And let all things be done in order, in decency and in order. That's what the Bible says. Let's keep going. Get ready to close this out. I'm messing with this. See? Let's go to Isaiah 30, verse 1. Woe to the rebellious children, saith the Lord, that take counsel, but not of me, and that cover for the covering, but not of my spirit, that they may add sin to sin. Did we not just read, we must be born again in the spirit? Who is his counsel? See, we got to take our time. Who is the counsel? The prophets, the apostles, in which the doctrine is built on. When you read Acts 2 and 42, and I think the other one is Ephesians 2 and 22. So why in the hell are we deviating from the spirit in which we learn from? That cup that was pouring down from Yahweh Shai, poured over to the... Look at, you ever seen these little fountains where you got multiple cups in a pyramid formation? And the water pours down from the source, which is Yahweh Shai, through the apostles to the prophets and to the teachers and the rest of the remnant. So you don't get that water supply if you're outside of that cup of pyramids or pyramid of cups. Let's go back to it. I'll show you what I'm talking about. See? John 3 and 5. Yahweh Shai answered, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born of water and of the Spirit, he cannot enter into the kingdom of God. There's one baptism, one Spirit. One Lord, one doctrine, one brotherhood. So the same rebels are being identified in these last days. I know you see it. Isaiah 30, verse 1. Woe to the rebellious children, saith the Lord, that take counsel, but not of me, and that cover with a covering, but not of my spirit, that they may add sin to sin. See? So the mouth of the Lord is speaking, that have the instruction booklet, that have the overarching strategy of the great master chess player. Go to verse 2. That want to go down into Egypt and have not asked at my mouth, to strengthen themselves in the strength of Pharaoh and to trust in the shadow of Egypt, looking at what we can see in the physical, but not asking at the mouthpiece of the Lord, which are the prophets. It is the Spirit that speaks to us, not what we can physically see. His mouth are the mouthpiece of the prophets. Isaiah 34, verse 16. Seek ye out of the book of the Lord and read. No one of these shall fail. None shall want her mate. For my mouth it hath commanded, and his spirit it hath gathered them. See? So are we going to ignore the mouth and the spirit that's flowing unto us with these fountains of living water? and deviate from the source that fed us in the first place? Are we going to make it a habit to slap the hand that quenched our thirst, that fed us when we were hungry, that gave us water to drink when we were thirsty, that gave us comfort? Isaiah 34, verse 16. Seek ye out of the book of the Lord and read. No one of these shall fail, none shall want her mate. For my mouth it hath commanded, and his spirit it hath gathered them. Not our own doing. This is not a man-made movement. This is a spiritual phenomenon occurring in these last days. I think we read that. We'll close out here. Go to Romans 8, verse 8. So then, they that are in the flesh cannot please the Most High. Let's try to count the 144,000. Let's put our finger on King David. What chess player you know is going to just say, he's right here, he's standing right here. There's the king. Look at him. He's right here. That's retarded, okay? And I mean that in the way of willful ignorance. I'm not talking about somebody that's seriously sick, but willful ignorance. The chess player has given the hopeful elect his mind, his strategy, through Yahawashi, the mind of Yahawashi. Whenever Yahawashi was called king, he went to go hide. Did not he go and hide in John chapter 6? Did not King David go and hide in caves to escape persecution of his enemies? So why in the hell would a chess player say, oh, here he is right here. He's right here. That's retarded. So the right thing to do is follow the instruction book that we're given. That King David will be raised up in the appointed time. And the apostles are teaching that. So we are teaching the same doctrine the apostles are teaching. Romans 8, verse 8. So then, they that are in the flesh cannot please the Most High. But ye are not in the flesh, but in the Spirit. If so be that the Spirit of God dwell in you. Now, if any man have not the spirit of Hamashiach, he is none of his. And if Hamashiach be in you, the body is dead because of sin, but the spirit is life because of righteousness. So this body of what we can feel, see, touch, and taste must take a back seat from the movement of the spirit that's guiding and directing us, in which we were given leaders to follow and support. These are our spiritual fathers on earth. The ancient spirits are resurrected and are back on the earth. So are we going to stop believing that? If we throw out one part of the doctrine, then that means it's going to be a domino effect. We're going to begin to attack the entire doctrine. So sin is a slippery slope because it sets everything up to fail, to fall. A little leaven leaveneth the whole lump. So it spoils the entire work because of rebellion, disobedience, willful ignorance. Hopefully this lesson has been edifying. All praises to Yahweh, Bahashem Yahawashi, Bahashem Rukwakwadash. Double honor and respect to the elders and the apostles and great millstone. Much respect and honor to the brothers that are doing the work in truth and sincerity, risking their lives and freedom to do so, pushing this gospel throughout the four corners of the earth. The tabernacle of David is being raised up, resurrected from the dead, rebuilt from the ashes. Hopefully this lesson has been edifying. Kwame Yasharala and Abad Babal Barakatham. We got next, Lord willing. Shalom.